بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد Baraka, blessings, is something which everybody seeks. So generally, when we meet a believer, we say Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Yeah, also in our daily greeting and meeting, we also asking for barakah, blessings. So this is a very valuable commodity which the people of batil cannot comprehend. Likewise, when we make dua for somebody, barakallahu fi, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put blessings, etc. Ramadan Mubarak, may this be a blessed month. Somebody gets married, then dua is made for them. Barakallahu lakuma wa baraka alaykuma wa jama'a baynakuma bi khayrin. Dua for baraka in the nikah is also made. In the worldly sense, the people of batil, generally a person steals, a person robs, a person lies, a person deceives. They snatching their barakah, they depriving themselves of barakah. But because this is not a concept which anybody can grasp, it's not a logical concept, people are very, very negligent with regards to it. So, say there was a lawyer and he had a son who was a genius. So the son said, I want to follow in your footsteps. So the father said, no problem. He went to law school. He graduated with top honors. And he joined the father's law firm. So on the first day he came to work, he requested for a file. And by the end of the day, he cracked the file. By the end of the day, he cracked the file. So he came happily to his father and he said, guess what? I've cracked the formula for the file on the accident which you've been working for the last 4 years. So the father became very upset and started shouting him and said, you fool, why do you think I put you in law school for? Why did I put you in law school? So the idea is to extort, whether it's a lawyer in the medical field, a pregnant female does not need cesarean, but it is rushed. Likewise, many other situations in life where deception is of the highest level and extortion has no limits and boundaries. So, baraka. Likewise, tabarak, which is the meaning of blessed. And who's the most blessed? Tabarakas murabbika dhil jalali wal ikram. That the name of Allah, the owner of majesty and honor, is most blessed and blessed. Fatabarakallahu ahsanul khaliqin. So blessed be Allah, the best of creators. Tabarakalladhi biyadihil mulk. Blessed is he, that great being, whose hands is the sovereignty. Tabarakalladhi nazzalal furqan. Blessed is that being who sent down Furqan, the criterion. Tabarakalladhi, tabarak ismu rabbika. Different ayat explaining the greatness of Allah. Then Anbiya alayhimu salatu wassalam were blessed as well. And for example, Isa alayhi salam said, waja'alani mubarakan aynama kuntu. Allah made me blessed wherever I am. Likewise, Ibrahim, Ishaq alayhim as-salatu was-salam, wa barakna alayhi wa ala Ishaq. And we blessed Ibrahim and Ishaq. So, from Allah to His Anbiya, to the places of Barakah, the Baytullah, inna awwala baytin wudhi'a lin-nasi lalladhi bi-Bakkah mubarakah. The first house of worship established for mankind was in Mecca. Mubarakah, and very blessed, very Mubarak. So the Baytullah, the land of the Baytullah, that's all Mubarak. The land of Sham and the surrounding areas. Subhanalladhi asra bi'abdihi laylan minal masjidil haram. So from Masjid al-Haram to Masjid al-Aqsa, alladhi barakna hawlahu, which the surroundings there we've blessed. وَنَجَّيْنَاهُ وَلُوطًا إِلَى الْأَرْضِ الَّتِي بَارَكْنَا فِيهَا لِلْعَالَمِينَ. So Lut alayhi salam to the land which we had blessed for the worlds. Again, وَلِسُلَيْمَانَ الرِّيحَ عَاسِفَةً تَجْرِي بِأَمْرِهِ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ الَّتِي بَارَكْنَا فِيهَا. That land, Sulaiman al-Islam, the wind that blew forcefully, which followed the command, but we had blessed. وَجَعَلْنَا بَيْنَهُمْ وَبَيْنَ الْقُرَى الَّتِي بَارَكْنَا فِيهَا. And we blessed, placed between them and the cities which we had blessed, many visible cities. وَأَوْرَثْنَا الْقَوْمَ الَّذِينَ كَانُوا. So, here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also explains that the people who had been oppressed to inherit the eastern regions of the land and the western ones, which بَارَكْنَا فِيهَا, we had blessed. Then Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam, after the floods, he said, رَبِّي أَنزِلْنِي مُنزَلًا مُبَارَكًا. Allah, let me land at the blessed landing place, at the blessed Mubarakah. Likewise, you said, Ya Nuhu bit bi salamin minna wa barakatin alayka. This embark from the security of Allah and blessings. Then, if we want to see a barakah as well, a place of barakah, like we said, the Baytullah, then Nabi alayhi salam made dua for Madinatul Munawwara, where there's barakah. Allahumma ja'al bil madinati dhi'fay ma ja'alta bi Makka min al barakah. That Ya Allah, increase in Medina double, twice the blessings that is on Makka. Then the time of barakah. So if we're searching, we should see, we can be in the places of barakah. The time of barakah. Inna anzalnahu fi laylatin mubarakah. We send down the Quran during the blessed nights, the night of Laylatul Qadr, the night of power, is blessed. Likewise, the time. Tasaharu fa inna fi suhuri barakah. At the time of Sari, there is barakah. Likewise, barakatu ummati fi bukuriha, in the early part of the morning, there is blessings and barakah. Then which items have barakah? The greatest of which is the kalam of Allah, the book of Allah. وَهَذَا كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ مُبَارَكُ. The Quran, which we revealed, was Mubarak. كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ إِلَيْكَ مُبَارَكَ. Again, this book which we revealed to you is Mubarak. وَهَذَا ذِكْرٌ مُبَارَكٌ. Again, the Quran. وَهَذَا كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ. So different ayat describing how Mubarak the Quran is. Then specific surah as well. اِقْرَأُوا سُورَةَ الْبَقَرَةِ فَإِنَّ أَخْذَهَا بَرَكَةٌ. That recites Surah Baqarah, for it is a blessing to hold steadfast on it. There is blessing. A person leaves it, there'll be grief. And in the foods, what foods is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put barakah? يُوْقَدُ مِن شَجَرَةٍ مُبَارَكَةٌ. يُوْقَدُ مِن شَجَرَةٍ مُبَارَكَةٌ. The oil of the blessed olive tree. So, Watin was Zaytun, the olive tree is Mubarak, then rain is Mubarak. وَنَزَّلْنَا مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً مُبَارَكًا. We have sent down rain, which is Mubarak from the heavens. So, if we look at the rain as well, then Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, when it began to rain, once he uncovered a portion of his body to allow the rain to fall on his body, he removed a part of his clothing so that the rain water would fall on his body. Sahaba inquired, O Nabi of Allah, what's the hikmah wisdom? He said, O kama qal, this has come from Allah. This has come from Allah. Likewise, the first rain of the season when it fell, Nabi alayhi salam and Sahaba would uncover their heads and allow the rain to fall directly on them. And Nabi alayhi salam would say that the rain has just come from Allah, which contains barakah, blessings. Also, Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma used to bath in rain and he would read this ayah of barakah. Imam Nawawi rahimahullah has written that it is sunnah to let the first rain of the season fall upon one's body. So that's a dormant sunnah. We should try to make it alive. The first rains of the season to fall on us. Likewise, other foods that have barakah. إِذَا أَفْتَرَ أَهَدُكُمْ فَلْيُفْتِرْ عَلَىٰ تَمْرٍ. That when you make iftar, you break your fast, you should use a kajur. فَإِنَّهُ barakah, because there is blessings in the date. بَيْتٌ لَا تَمْرَ فِيهِ جِيَعَ. That house where there is no kajur, the household are filled with hunger. So barakah again in different foods. So different things Allah has put barakah in. We need to be searching for those mediums of barakah. Allahumma la mani'a lima a'tayt, what Allah has decided to grant you, nobody can stop it. Wala mu'ti lima mana'at, and what Allah prevents something, nobody can grant you. Wala yanfa'u, benefit is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So how do we get this barakah? Firstly, number one, our life should be based on the awamir of Allah, and we should see what should I do in my life. And for knowing what to do, we need to read istikhara from every matter, every decision. We should read istikhara. Number two, we should make mashwara. Ma khaba man istikhara. Whoever makes istikhara will not lose. They will not lose out. They will not be deprived. Wala nadima man istashara. And the one who makes mashwara, mutual consultation, will not have any regret. So go to somebody to make mashwara. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا قَبْلَكَ إِلَّا رِجَالًا نُوحِي إِلَيْهِمْ فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ. Ask the أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ. So specific people who are expert in fields, ask them, the friends of Allah, when we want to know about deen. Likewise, number three, when a transaction is being done, then it should be honesty. So البيئان بالخيار ما لم يتفرقا, that the buyer and the seller have an option of cancelling or confirming the bargain, the deal, the trade, unless they separate. And فإن صدقا, if they are truthful and they made clear the defects and the deficiencies, then بُورِكَ لَهُمَا فِي بَيْعِهِمَا, in their transaction, there'll be barakah and blessings. وَإِن كَذَبَا وَكَتَمَا, but if they speak lies and they hide the deficiencies and the flaws, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala مُحِقَتْ بَرَكَةُ بَيْعِهِمَا, the barakah and the blessings of their transaction, they are deprived of that. وَيْلٌ لِلْمُطَفِّفِينَ, when weighing, make sure there is justice. Likewise, another riwayah, الْحَلِفُ مُنَفِّقَةٌ لِلسِّلْعَةِ مُمْحِقَةٌ لِلْبَرَكَةِ, that the seller who swears and takes oaths to persuade the buyer to purchase the goods, then that swearing may be a means that he will be deprived of Allah's blessing. So he may persuade the person to buy and to purchase that goods by swearing, and you'll say, Wallah, Tallah, Allah, no, Qasam, Khudana, that it is like this and it is from this century, etc. He will lie and deceive, but his Qasams will deprive him of Barakah. So if we need to explain to somebody something, we don't need to dramatize it, be dramatic. Iyyakum wa kathrata al-halif al-bay', be careful of making a lot of oaths when doing a transaction. So likewise, a person wants to take a loan. Man akhadha amwal an-nasi yuridu ada'aha. You took money, you want to borrow it, but you want to pay it back. Addallahu an. Allah will put barakah in no matter what situation you in. Allah will put barakah in this person's life. He will pay it off. وَمَنْ أَخَذَ يُرِيدُ إِتْلَافَهَا أَتْلَفَهُ اللَّهُ. And a person takes it to just carry on borrowing from people but no sincere intention of paying back, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will destroy, remove all the barakah. Likewise, a person gets involved in interest. وَذَرُوا مَا بَقِيَ مِنَ الرِّبَى. So a person gets engaged in interest, then فَأْذَنُوا بِحَرْبٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ. He is declaring, be warned of the war with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So a person who has war with Allah can never have any barakah. Likewise, we want barakah, then a person should engage in sadaqah. A person should engage in sadaqah. So when a person engages in sadaqah, number 4, then they will have barakah. يَمْحَكُ اللَّهُ الرِّبَى وَيُرْبِي الصَّدَقَاتِ. That Allah destroys interest and gives increase for charity. And there's many riwayat of how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increases the barakah in a person who is charitable, which is an entire topic on its own. Number 5. To join family ties. مَنْ أَحَبَّ أَن يُبْسَطَ لَهُ فِي رِزْقِهِ. The person wants and loves that he be granted more blessings in his wealth and in his life. He wants his life to be prolonged. فَلْيَسِلْ رَحِمَهُ. Then he should keep good relations with his family, with his kith. So, other riwayat, man ahabba ayyumadda lahu fi umrihi. You want a long life, barakah in your life, barakah in time, wa ayyuzada lahu fi rizqihi. And you want to become, in our terms, rich, today people are saying. But we say an increase in his risk means the barakah in risk. So, rich is a very detrimental word. I want barakah in my risk should be used. فَلْيَبَرَّ وَالِدَيْهِ. Then you should be good to your parents and keep joint ties. So there was a person who had 4 sons. When he became ill, one of the sons told the other 3, either you nurse him in his sickness and you would not receive anything from his estate, or I would nurse him without any claim from the estate. They agreed. Obviously it was wealth and everybody wants to maximize and capitalize on the dunya. He looked after his father and he passed away. He did not take anything from the estate. And one day he saw in a dream a person telling him that there's 100 gold coins buried at such a place. And it was for him. So he asked the person if that money was blessed. Was there barakah in it? So he said, no, there was no barakah in it. So he told his wife the next morning, who insisted about taking the money. He did not agree. Then the next night again, he seen the same dream, but the person told him 10 gold coins at a certain place. When he was asked again if there was barakah in there, the reply was the negative. He related the dream again to his wife, who insisted that she should go. She said, you better go and take it. This is an opportunity. What are you waiting for? So again, in the third night, he did not comply and he said, I will be patient. And he seen a dream again. And in that dream, he said, only 1 dinar. So he asked again, if there was barakah in it. The reply came, yes, there is barakah. So he went and he took the dinar, he purchased two fish, and he brought it home. The wife cut the fish open, and she found an invaluable pearl in the stomach of each fish. Both these pearls were sold, was put on the market. Nobody could come to the value. The king of the country could afford it, and he was paid 99 mule loads of gold. 99 mule loads of gold. So how much barakah Allah gave him? The amal for today is 7 people will be under the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of them is وَرَجُلٌ تَصَدَّقَ بِصَدَقَةٍ فَأَخْفَاهَا, that he gave sadaqah but it was secretly. So the amal is to give secretly sadaqah and try best not to notify people and make it known. May Allah give us tawfiq of making amal. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen.